previous lecture, we have seen a lot of examples about metric space. So you can now show that whenever any state, non-empty state is given and the definition of distance function is given, then if you are asked to check whether this particular state along with that distance function is a metric space or not, for that you have to check all those four properties, and if all those four properties are satisfied, then you can declare that it is a metric space. In that respect, I will give you some exercises. First is, this is first exercise, for all x and y belonging to say R or say C, state of complex numbers. If you take distance between x and y as say minimum of two values, two real numbers, 1 and mod of x minus 1. Prove that B is a metric. This is one example. Secondly, second example is this, that let XD be a metric space. XD be a metric space. So you are given that this is a metric space. So B satisfies all the properties for the set X. And let K greater than 0, that means K is positive, fixed real number. Fixed real number. Then, for all x and y belonging to x, you define d star xy as k into dxy. D star xy is k into dxy. Then prove that d star is a metric on x. So why this example is important? This gives you the way to develop another metric whenever I know particular function is a metric. So when I know D is metric, and if you take K, which is greater than 0, fixed real number, it is positive, fixed real number, then D star xy is defined as K into dxy. This is also a metric. D star is a metric on x. So this particular example you can use to generate different metrics whenever first metric is known. Third example, this we will solve here. Let x comma d be a metric space. X comma d be the metric space. Then for all x and y belonging to x, for all x and y belonging to x, define d star xy as dxy upon 1 plus dxy. Dxy upon 1 plus dxy. And also define d double star xy as minimum of 1 and dxy. Then prove that d star and d double star are both metrics on x.
examples that I am giving to you or following, they give the way to develop different mental spaces whenever I know a particular mental space. Here also, you know that you are given that D is a metric. If D is a metric space on X, it means what D is a metric on X. You are proving Dishtha is a metric on X. And this Dishtha is defined by using D. Here also, already I know that D is a metric on X. I am defining D star by dxy upon 1 plus dxy, and D double star is minimum of 1 and dxy. So you are already using a metric D and developing a new metric. So these are the very good examples, because this gives you the way to develop what we can say series of metric spaces, series of metrics whenever I know a particular metric. Out of all these examples, we will discuss this one. D star xy, definition is dxy upon 1 plus dxy, and we want to prove that it is a metric on x. Now for that, what we have to do is, we have to verify all those four different properties that we have seen about the metric space. So here, what can be done? Example 3, out of that part 1 we are discussing. So you are given here that we are given, what is given? Given if xd is a metric space. I will write henceforth m dot s dot for metric space. Remember, so x comma t is a metric space. Okay. What you know by this statement? You know that dxy is greater than or equal to 0 for all x and y belonging to x. Dxy is 0 if and only if x is equal to y. Then we know symmetry property, dxy is same as dyx, and also we have another inequality, dxy is less than or equal to dxz plus dzy for all x, y and z belonging to x. This is what I know because I am given xd is a matrix. Now my definition of d star is this. So d star xy is what? It is dxy upon 1 plus dxy for all x and y belonging to x. Now first thing that I want to prove is, to prove that, what I have to prove? D star x comma y is greater than or equal to 0. This I must prove. And this is obvious because dxy is greater than or equal to 0. Now suppose it is 0, then 1 plus dxy, because if dxy is 0, this will be 0 upon 1. It will not be 0 upon 0. This 1 is important. That is why this will be 0. And if it is not 0, which it will be greater than 0, then in this case dxy upon 1 plus dxy will be what I can say, quotient of two positive numbers, positive real numbers. So it will be greater than or equal to 0 in any case. So here I can say, as dxy is greater than or equal to 0, it implies dxy upon 1 plus dxy is also greater than or equal to 0. Okay, do you agree with this? Because this is given to you. Dxy is greater than or equal to 0, we know, because we already have given xd is a metric space. So this follows. So first property is true. Here we can say d star xy. So that implies d star xy is greater than or equal to 0 for all x and y belonging to x. Now second property we want to prove. To prove that d star xy is equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to y. This we want to prove. I think this is very simple because we already know that d is a metric space. So we know that dxy is equal to 0 if and only x is equal to y. Now here I have to prove d star xy. So d star xy is what? It is dxy upon 1 plus dxy. But out of that, numerator dxy is equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to y. Ok? Okay, so this result dxy is 0 if and only if x is equal to y implies d star xy totally depends on numerator here. And so here I can say this implies d star xy is equal to 0 if and only if dxy is 0. And dxy is 0 if and only if x is equal to y. So it follows. Very simple. Second property is also true. Now we will go for the third property. That means symmetry, which is very obvious. Third property. D star xy is equal to what? Dxy upon 1 plus dx, 1. Now this I can rewrite as dxy, you can write as dyx upon 1 plus dyx. Why this we can write as d being a metric, dx, y is dy, x. And now this thing actually is same as d star y, x. So we have proved d star xy is equal to d star yx for all x and y belonging to this. So that is done, symmetric property. Now fourth property is important, now primary inference. For that what we will do is, we will start with d star xy. What I have to prove is, to prove that for all x and y and z belonging to x, we have to prove d star xy is less than or equal to d star xz plus d star zy. This is what I have to start. So we will start with d star xy. This is equal to dxy upon 1 plus dxy. This I can write as 1 minus, this is important statement. This I can write as 1 minus 1 upon 1 plus dxy. Will you actually do this? See, check it. If I subtract this, it will be 1 plus dxy into 1 minus 1. So it is just dxy upon 1 plus dxy. So same thing I am doing. So this is important. This step is important. Okay. Now what? See, I know that as d is a metric on x, as d is metric on x, for all x, y and z belonging to x, we know that dxy is less than or equal to dxz plus dzy. This is what we know. This is what we know because we are already given that d is a metric on x. So now dxy is less than or equal to dxz plus dzy, and your d star xy is 1 minus 1 upon 1 plus dxy. So what I will do is add 1 on both sides. I want to get this quantity. So I will add 1 on both sides. So 1 plus dx, y will be less than or equal to 1 plus dx, z plus dz, y. Obviously, because we are adding on both sides a positive real number. So less than or equal to will remain less than or equal. Then I will take reciprocal because I want to develop this thing. This is same as d star x. So reciprocal when I take, this will become greater than or equal to. So 1 upon 1 plus dxy will be what? It will be greater than or equal to 1 upon 1 plus dx, z plus b z, y. Okay. But we are not just interested in 1 upon 1 plus dxy, it is 1 minus this. So I will give minus sign on both sides.
So it will be minus 1 upon 1 plus dxy. And now as it is negative sign taken on both sides, this will become less than or equal to. So that will become less than or equal to minus of 1 upon 1 plus dxz plus dzy. Is it okay? Are you understanding all this? Give importance to these inequalities that we are writing. And whenever you are adding the positive real number on both sides, this inequality remains same. But here what is done is reciprocals are taken. So inequality reverse, less than or equal to becomes greater than or equal to. Then minus sign is done. On both sides we have minus sign is given means what? On both sides we are multiplying by minus 1. And so again it will revert. Now you will add 1 because I want this. So I have to add 1 now. So by adding 1, everything remains less than or equal will remain. Because 1 is a positive real number that we are adding. So 1 upon 1 plus dxy will be less than or equal to 1 minus 1 upon 1 plus dxz plus dzy. But now this is d star xy. Is it right? This is d star xy. On the left hand side, we have d star xy. We can, for example, if you want, you can write this thing, d star xy 1 minus 1 upon 1 plus dxy as the result 1. So this by 1 I can write as d star xy, and this is less than or equal to, if you subtract this, what I get? 1 plus dxz plus dzy into 1 minus 1. So 1 gets cancelled, and what remains on the numerator, in the numerator is dx, z plus dz, y, and divided by 1 plus dxz plus dzy. This is what we get. Now this I can split like this, dxz upon 1 plus dxz plus dzy plus dzy upon 1 plus dxz plus dzy. This way I can split. Okay, numerator first term upon whole the denominator. And second term upon whole the denominator. Okay. Now see this dxz upon 1 plus dxz if I take, because what is our definition of d star xy? Dxy upon 1 plus dxy. So if I retain only dxz upon 1 plus dxz and I remove this from the denominator. What do you mean by removing something from the denominator which is greater than or equal to 0? This D is a metric. That means I know already that dzy is something which is greater than or equal to 0. If it is 0, this is same as this. If it is greater than 0, that means what? Some positive real number from the denominator I am removing. That means I am making denominator smaller. I am removing positive real number. Suppose denominator is 7 and I subtract 2 from that. Denominator I make 5, numerator is same. So if denominator's value is lessened, value will increase. And so this quantity will be less than or equal to, because equal to is also possible if it is 0, less than or equal to what? Dxz upon 1 plus dxz. And same story here, it will be dzy. What will be written here? This will be removed, 1 plus dzy. See, we are removing some positive real number, non-negative, not necessarily positive, non-negative real number from the denominator, and so quantity will increase. But this is what? By definition, this is what? This is d star xz. And this is what? D star zy. Okay, and now d star xz plus d star zy. So all finally we have produced d star xy is less than or equal to d star xz plus d star zy. So triangular equality is proved. That is, d star xy is less than or equal to d star x comma z. This comma I did not say. D star xz means d star x comma z plus d star z comma y. For all x, y, z, belonging to x. Very standard problem. So this proves that whenever you are given that d is a metric on x, d star is also a metric on x, where d star's definition is dxy upon 1 plus dxy. So very, very important problem, and this also gives you varieties of ways to prove that from a particular metric you can develop some other metric. Now this problem can be generalized. I will give you another example and an exercise. Another exercise I will give. Okay, it is something like this exercise. Let XD be a metric space. Prove that D star XY. Prove that XD star is also a metric space, where D star XY is MDXY upon 1 plus DXY, where M is fixed positive real number. This is more general, because in this particular example, if you replace M by 1, I mean previous example. So all such things we must be able to do, proving that given the function is a metric on the given set. For that you know now various varieties of problems now we have done, and now these examples we know now that we have to prove those four properties. If those four properties are proved, then you can declare that it is a metric space. Another exercise. I expect that all these exercises are done. Exercise is like this, that let D and D star be matrix on X. This is given. Prove that. Two things. First is D plus D star is also a metric on X. In particular, deduce 2D is a metric on X. Now this is very simple, because 2D is a, what we can do is, if you prove this D plus D star is a metric, you replace D star by D, it will be 2D. Or in previous example we have proved that K into D is also metric, where K is fixed positive real number. That also you can use to prove that 2D is a metric. So once you know D is a metric, KD is a metric, already we have given you as an example. So if you can do that, then this also follows, because you just replace K by 2 and write the proof. But this is in general, D and D star are two metrics, so they satisfy all the properties of the metric, and you have to prove D plus D star is a metric. Another example, that is maximum of D and D star is a metric on X. Maximum of D and D star. What do you mean by this? Suppose this I take by say D double star. So suppose I write D double star is maximum of D and D star. What actually it means is, if you take X and Y belonging to X, you calculate D X Y, it will be some real number. D star X Y will be some real number. Out of them, maximum you take, that will be D double star X comp. So that is also a metric you will try to prove. So these are various things now that we have done. This is the basic requisite of the first part of your course, that whenever a particular non-empty set is given and a definition of D is given, then you have to prove that X is a metric with respect to, or X is a metric space with respect to that D. That means you have to prove D is a metric. What do you mean by proving D is a metric? All those four properties you try to check in case of D. If all those four properties are valid, then you will declare D is a metric. And various examples now we have seen how to generate different metrics whenever I know particular metric is there. Suppose D is a metric, then we know now D star is a metric where D star is DXY upon 1 plus DXY. D star XY is MDXY upon 1 plus DXY. If you have D is a metric, K into D is also a metric. If you have D and D star two metrics, then D plus D star is also a metric. Maximum of D and D star is also a metric. Then all such examples we have done, and this only proves that there are many examples that we can produce whenever I know a particular metric, that is particular function is a metric. Now we will go to second part of this course, where we have to study actual metric topology. See, actually definition of topology is the study of open sets and then related things. So here we are going to discuss about metric spaces. Now in previous classes, you have studied open sets, closed sets, closure of the set, union of open sets, intersection of open sets, etc. and various properties related to these sets, but they were only in case of real line. Now this is a more general canvas. We are discussing metric space. So R is an example. Special case is R. This is the general thing that we are doing. Whenever I study metric topology, I am not just related with R. I am not just studying R2. I am not just studying R3. R2, R3, R, etc. are particular examples of the metric space. And in real analysis, whenever you study it, the distance between the two real numbers was always taken as mod of x minus 1. Here it is not so. Your D can be any definition. Only if it satisfies all those four properties, it becomes a distance between the two elements in that set. So this is more general thing that we are doing. And so the study of open sets, closed sets, etc. becomes very important whenever our domain is not just a set of real numbers, but it is a set of actually a metric space. So we are now studying in the second part open spheres or open sets, we can say open sets in metric space. Open sets in the metric space. So to begin with, we will define what is meant by open sphere. We will define what is meant by open sphere in metric space. Okay. The concept is like this. Now suppose you have a metric space x, d. Now you know what it means by x, d. X, d is a metric space. This is given to you. Okay. And suppose I take x belonging to capital X. Any element of capital X if I take. Okay. And suppose r greater than 0. Is a real number. R greater than 0 is a real number. Then we are going to define open sphere. Open sphere with center at x. Center at x and radius r. Center at x and radius r. And we will denote it by S, x, r. Center at x, radius r. Sphere, so I have taken S. Different authors use different notations. Some authors use this notation, S, r, x. This is also okay. Whatever you are comfortable with, you can use. I am going to use this, S, x, r. S means sphere, x is the center, r is the radius. So, the definition of this will be like this. Sxr is equal to, this is the set of y belonging to x, elements in x. What are those elements? Well, their distance from x is less than r. So, we will say distance xy less than r. This is the definition. So, open sphere
is defined like this. You have to clearly understand what this means. I am saying that this is open sphere with center at x and radius r. Okay, so all the points in the metric space which are at a distance less than r from x will be checked. You can compare this with circle with radius r and center at x. All the points inside circle, what is their distance from the center? Less than radius. So same terminology actually you can follow. But now one simple remark about this open sphere, when you take it, is always non-empty. Why non-empty? Because it always contains its center. Without center there cannot be open sphere. So open sphere is always, any metric space you take, any open sphere you take, it will be always non-empty because it surely contains its center. Now what? Now we will support this with certain examples. Now suppose I take metric space, usual metric space you take, examples now. Examples. Consider first example. Suppose I take R, D. Usual metric D is usual metric on R. Now this usual metric, always you will say, it means dxy is what? Mod of x minus y. This is meant by usual metric. Dxy is mod of x minus y. Okay. If this is your definition of the metric, now I want to say find Sxr. What will be Sxr? By definition it is what? Y belonging to R. Because this x will be replaced by R now, R is the set. Y belonging to R such that dxy less than R. But what does this mean? It means y belonging to R such that dxy equal mod of x minus y. Mod of x minus y is less than R. Means what? This will be what? Open interval x minus R to x plus R. You can easily see, suppose this is real line and this is your x. What is Sxr? It is the set of points in R whose distance from x, because x is the center, is less than R. So you will add R on this side, x plus R, because always you know R is a positive real number, so x plus R will be greater than x, and on this side same distance x minus R. So all the numbers between x minus R and x plus R, when you check, what is this distance from x? Less than R. If you go beyond this, this distance is R, this distance is also R. If you go beyond this, distance from x will be greater than R, which is not included. Here our definition says dxy is less than R. So in short, whenever you take R as a metric space, with usual metric in R, when you say many times now in this series of lectures, I will say usual metric on R. Each time I will not write dxy mod of x minus y, it means this we should know. So that will be an open interval. So what we can conclude from this? Open sphere in case of real numbers as a metric space with usual metric is always open interval. So open sphere is an open interval in case of usual metric defined on R. As a numerical example, if you take, suppose I take in particular, if I take S 5, 1, what do you mean by this? 5 is the center and 1 is the radius. So this will be what? Open interval 5 minus 1, 5 plus 1. So it will be what? Open interval 4, 6. You can see any real number you take from between 4 and 6. Open interval means they do not include 4 and 6. So any real number between 4 and 6 where I take, its distance from 5 is what? Less than 1. Because 5 is the midpoint of that actually, 4 and 6. So 6 is not included in this, because the distance of 6 from 4 or distance of 6 from 5 is equal to 1. We want less than 1. So 4 or 6, they are not included. So when boundary points are not included, you know that interval is called open interval. And so whenever you think of open sphere in R, it is an open interval. Now second example we will do, because examples when you have, it makes your ideas clear. Second example, we will take similar type of thing. We will take R2 surface, R2 as a metric space, and D, where D is a usual metric on R2, B is usual metric on R2. This is also, once and for all, we will make the things clear. D is usual metric on R2 whenever you will say, what we are talking about, D is what? Euclidean distance. It means, this implies D is Euclidean distance. Means what? You know that if you have two points, say capital X is say x1, x2, and capital Y is say y1, y2, then dxy is what? It is root of x1 minus y1 bracket square plus x2 minus y2 bracket square. This is the definition of usual distance. So this is what? Euclidean distance. This is Euclidean distance on R2. This is Euclidean distance in R. So many times now in remaining lectures we will say that it is a usual distance. Usual distance, I did not write this definition each time. This is the usual distance. Now here, suppose I am calculating, or I am interested in finding what is S, x1, x2, this SXR, suppose I say, where X is x1, x2. It means what? We are interested in finding S, x1, x2, R. Means what? It is the set of points, what? Capital Y, such that distance between X and Y, capital Y belonging to what? R2, such that distance between x and y is less than r. It means what? It is the distance between x and y, this formula we have used. So it means distance root of x1 minus y1 bracket square plus x2 minus y2 bracket square is less than r. So if I make square, it is x1 square minus y1 square. x1 minus y1 bracket square plus x2 minus y2 bracket square is less than r square. You know this is definition of circle, this is equation of circle. In 12th standard you are studying, if you have h, k as the center, right, and radius is r, what is the equation of circle? X minus h bracket square plus y minus k bracket square is equal to r. Now it is equal to r square because we are talking about circle, on the circle this point, but whenever you take any point inside, this distance will be less than r square. From equal to R square, less than R square. So this is what? This you can rewrite as, this we can rewrite as y1 minus x1 bracket square plus y2 minus x2 bracket square is less than R square. So what is this? This is the equation of circle whose center is at x1, y. And radius is, and all the points inside circle with radius R with the center at x1, x2. So what we can say, in case of R2, what is the nature of open sphere? So, in case of in R2D, where D is the usual metric, open sphere with center at x1, x2 and radius R is what? Is interior of the circle. Interior of circle with center x1, x2 and R and radius. And radius R. So open sphere is same as circle in case of circle, means not circle actually, interior of the circle. In case of R2. Okay? Have you understood? In case of R, open sphere is just an interval. In case of R2, it is, in case of R, it is what? Open sphere is open interval. And in case of R2, it is what?
interior part of the circle whose center is x and radius is r. If you take set in R2, it will be circle. In R3, you can imagine it will be sphere. Sphere with center at x, radius r. Interior part of that sphere will be the open sphere in R3. So it changes. The nature of the open sphere goes on changing. Whenever you take R, it is open interval. Whenever you take R2, it is circle, interior of the circle. When you take R3, it is interior of the sphere. Okay? Now, fourth example we will do will be, suppose I take a discrete matrix. XD is a discrete matrix. Discrete matrix. And suppose X belongs to X and we are interested in finding what is SXR. What can be done? Can anyone imagine what will be SXR in case of a discrete matrix? Because here what happens is your R always, whenever I say R, what is the nature of R? Greater than 0. Positive real number. Okay. Now X is the center. SXR means what? It is the set of all points which are at a distance less than R from X. Now in discrete matrix space, you know the definition. You try to recollect the definition of discrete matrix space. What is it? In discrete matrix space, we know that dxy is equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to y. Otherwise, it is 1. And this is true for all x and y belonging to x. Right? This is the definition of discrete matrix. Discrete matrix actually. So here in SXR, I am interested in considering all those elements y belonging to x whose distance from x is less than r. Now this r is what? We know r is any positive real number. Now that positive real number can be 1, less than 1 or greater than 1 also. So three different cases if I take. Because it all depends on whether it is equal to or not equal to, etc. And the distances are either it is distance between two elements in discrete matrix space is either 0 or 1. So whatever R we are taking, it can have two values, three values. Either it will be 0, it will be either R is less than or equal to what we can say, less than 1. Or R can be greater than or equal to 1. Right? Because it is a positive real number, R can be less than 1 or R can be greater than or equal to 1. Okay. Now when this R is less than 1, then what is that distance? Possible distances are either 0 or 1. There is no other distance possible. So whenever I am saying R is less than 1, what can be the thing? Less than 1 means what? Either distance is 1 or 0. So less than 1 means 0. And when distance is 0, what is that y? Y is same as x. So in case of this discrete matrix space, SXR is nothing but singleton x. Okay? When what? When r is less than or equal to 1. Here I will take two cases like this, r less than or equal to 1 and r greater than. So when it is less than or equal to 1, either distance is 1 or it is less than 1. Right? Now distance is less than 1 means what? 0. And so SXR will be just singleton x. And when r is greater than 1, then what? If that radius I take greater than 1, then what? I am trying to find the points in the matrix space whose distance from center is less than that value. Greater than 1, suppose I, for example, particularly, suppose I assume that this greater than 1 distance r, here, value of r, suppose I take value of r as 2. Means what? I am trying to find the points SXR. In that, what will be happening? R is 2, suppose. R is 2, suppose. Then what I am taking here, y belonging to x, such that what? Distance between x and y is less than 2. Now less than 2 includes 1 also
and 0 also.
And when less than 2, that suppose the distance is 1, then what? Any element of capital X when you take other than X, its distance from X is 1. Otherwise it will be 0 when X and Y are equal. So in this case what you will get? Whole matrix space will be. Whole matrix space.
Because
distance is either 1 or 0. There is no other choice. Whenever I say greater than 1, R is greater than 1, then this SXR, in case of a discrete matrix space, is whole matrix space. And when R is less than or equal to 1, it is a single matrix. So this is the nature of the open spheres in discrete matrix space. Okay, so four different examples we have seen. In case of R, usual matrix. In case of R2, usual matrix. In case of R3, usual matrix. And in case of a discrete matrix space, discrete matrix space, not usual matrix. This is the definition of that matrix. In this case, either the open sphere is a singleton set or open sphere is a whole matrix space. It depends on what is your R. If R is less than or equal to 1, it is singleton X. And if R is greater than 1, it is whole X. Okay. So we will conclude this lecture here. This is just an introduction of open sphere and some simple examples we have seen. We will continue in the next one.